वेलकम बैक दोस्तों। सो टुडे वी विल बी लुकिंग एट पार्ट 14 ऑफ आवर एनवायरनमेंट एंड इकोलॉजी करंट अफेयर्स, राइट। सो आज हम प्रोजेक्ट्स, डिफरेंट पॉलिसीज, फ्रेमवर्क्स एंड डिफरेंट इनिशिएटिव्स इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट देखेंगे, ठीक है। सो द कंटेंट्स आर व्हाट इज द थर्ड पोल एंड व्हाट इज द थर्ड पोल एनवायरनमेंट, ओके। लेटर वी विल सी अबाउट द नेशनल इनोवेशंस इन द क्लाइमेट रेजिलिएंट एग्रीकल्चर। Please do remember that the climate resilient agriculture is very much important in the context of climate change. Later we will see about the tiger corridors in our country. There is another initiative called sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation. So this is in the context of our stubble burning. Okay, we will see in that particular context. Later we will look at the coastal flood warning system app for the Chennai. It is called as Seaflows Chennai, right? So what is that particular app? We'll look at the Bonn challenge. Remember, this is different from the Bonn convention. Forest landscape restoration and the Bonn challenge. India's first trading program to combat particulate air pollution. So which organization has started it and what is it? Later we'll look at the Indian Navy's environment conservation roadmap. Recently the Bihar government has banned tree felling, right? We'll also look into that. Later we'll look at the National Afforestation Program, Van Dhan Vikas Karyakramam, Parampagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Okay, so the last two are the government schemes, right? Let us see one by one. The first one is the third pole environment. So the third pole environment is an international research program that has been launched in 2009. Please do remember the Himalayas and the surrounding region is called as third pole because of its significant contribution towards the climate and climate change. So as we know that the other two poles are north and south pole. The reason why it is referred as third pole because of its contribution, right? So this focuses on the Tibetan plateau and surrounding mountain regions. We have already studied about the black carbon issue in our previous classes and how it is impacting the glacial retreats in the Himalayan region. The next topic is about the national innovation in climate resilient agriculture. So this is an initiative by IACR, that is the ICAR, that is Indian Council for Agriculture Research. So little bit background information regarding the ICAR. It is an autonomous organization and the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, right? So what does it do? It coordinates, guides, manages research and education in the agriculture field and the extended agriculture sector, that is horticulture, fisheries, animal sciences in our entire country. Okay, the next topic is of the tiger corridors in country. So Tiger Conservation Authority in collaboration with Wildlife Institute of India has published this document called as the Connecting Tiger Populations for the Long Term Conservation. Remember, habitat conservation is the best conservation, and according to BBC also, it has given one report. It said the continuum of such habitats establishes a proper conservation to increase its numbers. So according to this document, it has mapped 32 major corridors across the country. Okay, so this has come under the Tiger Conservation Plan, which is mandated. Compulsory, that is mandated under the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. In our earlier classes, we have seen about the National Tiger Conservation Authority. We have already learned that the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change is head of this. We have seen what are its functionaries, right? Please do recapitulate it. Next topic is about sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation. So this came in the context of stubble burning issue. So this is an initiative providing a sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation as a development effort that would benefit vehicle users, farmers and entrepreneurs. How? See, in the context of stubble burning, they also come up with one new kind of agricultural vehicles that removes this stubble and can be utilized can be used as a raw material for the other industries, right? We already discussed about the EPCA in the context of national capital region, right? The next topic is of the Seaflows Chennai. This is a kind of app that has been launched by the National Institute of Ocean Technology. So this is the India's first such integrated coastal flood warning system. So this is a GIS based decision, so geoinformatics system, and it forecasts the indentation up to 10 days in advance. So this is hosted and operated by National Center for Coastal Research. Now, with meteorological data inputs from the IMD, National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecasting, and Indian National Center for Ocean Information Services. See, INCOIS is centered in Hyderabad. The next topic is about the Bond Challenge. So, what is Bond Challenge? This is the global effort to bring 150 million hectares of the world deforested and degraded land into restoration by 2020, and that is 150. Later, the additional target is 350 million hectares by 2030. This is the target. Okay, so India kya contribution hai isme? India, from its side, it is contributing for restoration of 13 million hectares. Okay, of this, the degraded and forest land by the 2020, and 8 million additional by 2030. So, as I said, this is different from the Bonn Convention, that is on the migratory species. The next topic is about the forest landscape restoration. So, this comes in the context of Bonn Challenge itself. So, this is the center has, in line with this challenge, has launched this flagship project, okay, for the afforestation. Okay. So, this pilot program has already been implemented for the 3.5 years in the state, that is Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Nagaland and Karnataka. So, this restoration is an ongoing process of regaining of the ecological functionality and enhancing the human well-being across deforested and degraded lands, right? India's first raiding program to combat particulate matter air pollution. So this has been launched by the Gujarat Pollution Control Board. Remember, this is very much similar to the similar to the carbon emission reduction certificates. So jaise ye trade karte hain between the industries of polluting and the green industries, so similarly this has been brought by the Gujarat government. So similarly, those kind of industries will be exchanging in the context of the particulate matter. The next topic is the Indian Navy has formulated this environmental conservation roadmap for reduction in energy consumption, diversion of energy supply. Okay, so this is remember that additional information regarding the Indian Navy has voluntarily implemented this different schedules of MARPOL. We have already discussed about the MARPOL. So this is the prevention of the pollution from the ships, right? So Bihar government recently banned the tree felling. Okay, so this has brought under the Forest Conservation Act. Why? Because citing the increasing the pollution as well as the fatal heat wave that is spreading. Remember, forest is in concurrent list of the Schedule 7 of our Indian Constitution. So earlier it was in state list. It has brought in this concurrent list by 47th amendment. The next topic is about the National Afforestation Program. So this program is for regeneration of degraded forests, okay, and the adjoining areas through community participation or the people's participation. How it is implemented? This is implemented in decentralized manner at different stratas. State level test, State Forest Development Agency. At forest division level pe forest development agency, similarly joint forest management communities rahenge, kahan pe rahenge ve? Wo village level pe rahenge. So apart from this, please do remember, at a holistic level there are three such programs addressing these afforestation programs. So the ministry has three major schemes, that is the National Afforestation Program, that is we have seen, National Mission for the Green Ganga. This is one of such programs of our National Action Plan on the Climate Change. And finally, that is the Forest Fire Prevention and the Management Scheme. The next topic is Van Dhan Vikas Yojana. So, here I will give you one tip. please see that any government schemes try to find the etymology. Etymology का मतलब ये होता है उन शब्दों का क्या मतलब है. For example, यहाँ पे इस कार्यक्रम में if you see वन धन मतलब वन का मतलब फॉरेस्ट है, धन मतलब वेल्थ है. सो दिस इज रिगार्डिंग द फॉरेस्ट वेल्थ. विकास मतलब डेवलपमेंट, राइट. सो इससे दिस विल मेक यू लाइक इजीली क्रैक दिस काइंड ऑफ एमसीक्यूज. सो व्हाट डज इट डू, इट टारगेट्स द लाइवलीहुड जनरेशन फॉर द ट्राइबल पॉपुलेशन हु डिपेंडेंट ऑन दिस रिसोर्सेज फ्रॉम द फॉरेस्ट, राइट. हाउ, बाय यूजिंग द साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड हार्नेसिंग देयर ट्रेडिशनल नॉलेज एंड स्किल सेट्स. Please do remember that in the Biodiversity Act 2002, there is one section particularly addresses the local knowledge or the traditional knowledge of the local people regarding the biodiversity. The next scheme is about Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. So this is regarding the organic farming. So this has been adopted by the cluster approach. So cluster approach, they will take one group of farmers from the villages. So 50 or more, what is number of the farmers there, 50 or more who are having cumulative 50 acre land, right, to implement this organic farming. So this is been implemented using the two things, that is the soil health management and National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. So do focus on your continuous preparation, friends. Please do share your feedback and please visit these kind of videos and share with your friends in your lunch breaks, right. We'll see in next class. Till then, take care. Thank you.